Oh, whoa, I didn't see you there. This? It's all research. Maybe if you're like me, you're wondering, what the heck is this metaverse thing? Thanks to Facebook's renaming to Meta, the word metaverse seems to have popped up everywhere.
It's Meta. Meta!
There's a meta problem.
This word metaverse.
Just think about it.
Meta's version of the metaverse.
Metaverse.
There's humongous value in this concept of the metaverse.
Yikes, that's a lot to take in. Okay, let's just start with the basics. What is the metaverse? Turns out that question is not so easy to answer. So I turned to some experts to help me sort it all out.
My name's Annie Robertson. I'm a senior reporter at The Verge, and I cover a wide variety of topics around technology.
My name is Megan Smith. What I get to do is teach people how to make immersive experiences.
Hi, everyone. I am Annie Zhang, and I am the host of the Hello Metaverse podcast, as well as a product manager who's worked in various different companies building metaverse products.
Metaverse is made up of the prefix meta, which comes from ancient Greek, meaning beyond, paired with verse, from the universe. It's not necessarily its own separate universe, though. The metaverse will interact and be a part of the physical world.
So it's a layering on of new experiences.
And it's not one place or one thing, but it's a really broad idea.
The metaverse is the way for us to kind of talk about this future that we imagine like society to progress to.
It's a future vision of the internet where 3D virtual spaces come together to form a virtual universe.
If you want to get really technical, this sort of big virtual space where people hang out.
But it's not so easy to pin down.
More practically, the metaverse is either whatever people think comes after the current internet or whatever ties into the product that they are making or promoting.
Not everyone agrees with what the metaverse is or what it can be, but the main idea is virtual worlds that blend together. In the metaverse, people will be able to work, game, shop, travel, go to school. You're probably thinking, this metaverse thing sounds a lot like movies and TV shows I've watched. Think the virtual reality holodeck in Star Trek. Or the augmented reality of the holograms in Star Wars.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi.
A lot of people see the world of Ready Player One, the movie and the novel, as a version of the metaverse. I mean, just look at all the ways AR, VR, and the metaverse are showcased. Okay, but even though the metaverse is a vision of the future, it's not pure science fiction. There are ways that it already exists. Think Roblox, Fortnite, Animal Crossing, Minecraft. Even Justin Bieber's getting into the metaverse game.
I got my peaches out in Georgia. Ooh, yeah. I get my from California. That's that.
And kids like you and me, we are expected to be the generation to bring the metaverse to life.
Kids are driving the metaverse.
I think kids really need to take the concept seriously because they are going to be the ones that define the future of the metaverse.
There is a total possibility that things we think of as being metaverse engagement are things that are totally natural to people who are young right now and feel alien to people who are older.
The best thing at this stage is to learn, absorb, build opinions, and think critically about it.
Building a new internet and virtual worlds is all really exciting, but of course, with any new technology comes new problems and new fears.
It can be almost a little bit dystopian when you're thinking about a future where everyone's just plugged in and immersed into these virtual worlds at all times.
Some people are worried about who will own and set the rules in the metaverse. With big players like Facebook and Microsoft racing to launch new metaverse products, could a few big companies control this new world?
How do you we build that space without having one company or another having a monopoly over it.
Many people in the metaverse space are calling for more regulation to prevent scams, crime, and harassment in the virtual world.
It's kind of the Wild West right now.
But other people see the metaverse as a decentralized place, where communities and individuals define how things are run. So what do you think the metaverse could look like in the future? Who knows, maybe you'll be the one creating it. Well, that's it for KN Explains. For CBC Kids News, I'm Ameko Xmas Carroll. There was a lot of behind-the-scenes work and research that went into making this video. First off, I'd like to thank Megan Smith, Annie Zhang, and Addie Robertson. In addition, I used reporting from websites like CBC, Reuters, Slate, Forbes, and The Verge. We also used information from Facebook, Microsoft, and Roblox. Plus, special thanks to Game Changers VR for letting me test out their facilities.